the fall of Jerusalem. Wala nang may pagmalaki ang Jerusalem Christians after the fall of Jerusalem. Now, they were just refugees. Para silang mga asong ang buntot ay nakitlog at humihingi ng tulong sa kanilang mga ngayon kinikilalang kapatid, ang mga magenta Christians. It's like Catholicity was forced on them. So the full flowering of Catholicity in early Christianity is attributed to Paul and the apostles. And in daring to retrieve the Catholicity of the Israelite faith, they facilitated the definitive parting of ways with Judaism, because they opened up to the Gentiles. Ayun, that was the consequence, the immediate consequence of their having opened up to the Gentiles and parting of ways with mainstream Judaism. But it's very clear that our Catholicity really springs from Judeo-Christian faith, from our adherence to one God, creator of heaven, earth, and all humankind. It's the same God. So if it's the same God who created the Africans, the Chinese, if you really believe that it's the same God who created, how will you not believe that He cares for them as well, that He desires their salvation as well? So it springs also from our belief that humankind stands out as the unique creature whom God has made in His image and likeness to serve as co-creator of a world which is a world in progress. And it is likewise rooted in the conviction that our God is Trinity, meaning a communion of three persons, and that all of us creatures in God's image are called to reflect God's unity in our Catholicity. In our openness to build community among ourselves and thus grow in the likeness of God's unity. So you see, Catholicity is an attitude. And just because we call ourselves Catholic doesn't mean we are being true to what it means. I think this is the point, a very strong point of Pope Francis, when he started speaking about the need to go out to the peripheries, to open the doors of the church, and not to be a church that is closed in on itself and concerned only about its narrow churchy issues. A church that is only concerned about saving itself is not being Catholic. Salvation is really pointed to the world. Our mission is not just to one another. Our mission is to the world. How the world is transformed by the presence of the church is the big challenge of evangelization. Do we make a difference at all in society? That's what mission is about. So, medyo pasensya na kayo at napaka-technical na konti yung presentation about the meaning of Catholicity. So I really wanted to struggle to, you know, present to you a biblical, theological presentation of what it means to be truly Catholic. And that sometimes we're really being un-Catholic when our attitudes are bigoted attitudes, very discriminatory, uncharitable, and uncompassionate. And this is something that is shaking the church now, because Pope Francis is not yet accepted by all in the Catholic Church. there are people who suspect that Pope Francis is shaking the orthodoxy of the Church. I mentioned about Kariana, that's why they denounce Pope Francis. They call Pope Francis an Antichrist. They call him an anti-pope. And they suspect that he is compromising the doctrine and morals of the Church. And they suspect that his advocacy of mercy and compassion is a camouflage for compromising orthodoxy of the Church. And there are people who talk like that already. Just Google, check it out. You will see who they are. And almost always, this is coming from people who are consumed by the idea of righteousness, salvation only of the righteous, the select few, people who love to talk about hellfire for the rest of the world, only few will be saved. We used to think like that ourselves. Thanks be to God, we have emerged from that thinking. I think the Second Vatican Council is one of the most grace-filled developments in the history of the Church in the recent century. But where this will lead us, I do not know. So Pope Francis has declared this Jubilee of Mercy. And I would like to ask, I would like to motivate you to read the document. Misericordiae Vultus. And why some people are bound to misinterpret as compromising doctrine? Because for him, doctrine is secondary. His language is not doctrinal but pastoral. He comes across as a good shepherd who is more preoccupied with reaching out to the last, the least, and the least, rather than declaring who is righteous and who is unrighteous, who will be saved and who will not be saved. So, we're still in the realm of Catholicity, reflected on unity, holiness, and Catholicity. And already in our reflection on holiness, I brought in mercy, because Jesus' interpretation of holiness is really about mercy. Jesus is the face of the mercy of God, according to Pope Francis. Okay, so we will have our break and at 6 o'clock our Eucharistic celebration. And this evening we're going to have a lectio divina. But the evening lecture beginning is going to be done by groups, and the groups have been announced already. Apparently, the topmost name is to be regarded as the group leader. And please select your venue where you would like to come together for your lecture beginning. I do not know if you are already familiar with the basic pattern of the Lectio Divina. It's praying with the scriptures. So you can use the most basic pattern. The most common pattern which we are using on our team of priests at Holy Rosary Parish. Because I have a team of 5 priests and we meet together every Monday morning to discuss the coming Sunday's gospel, to pray. To pray together using the reading of the coming class, the coming Sunday. It's basically, starting with an opening prayer, and after the opening prayer, the same gospel would be read 3 times. Maybe assign somebody to read it the first time slowly, and as it is being read, just be paying attention to whatever line, word, or phrase that might be speaking strongly to you at that moment. And keep it in mind. And after it is read, then the first round of sharing is what is the applied phrase or word that strikes you particularly at that moment. So wala pang explanation. So that first round of sharing should be very quick, almost just 1 minute or less than 1 minute. And then, after a little pause, the reading will be read a second time. And after it is read a second time, as it is being read, you're asking yourself, what is there about that line? What is it in that line that God seems to be addressing to you at this particular moment? And then after the reading, then you can share to the second round of sharing. Bakit? Bakit yung linya niyo ang tumatawag sa sin sa akin ngayon? What is God seemingly telling me now, this moment, through that line in this gospel text? And then after having shared that, so yun ang mahaba yung second round of sharing. After having shared a second time, read the gospel a third time. And after reading the gospel a third time, share a prayer. Each one, you know, composes a personal prayer, short lang, in response to what the Lord has said to you through that word that you have shared. Okay? So, and then end with the Lord's Prayer. That's it. It shouldn't take much time. Please don't go beyond 1 hour. Yun lang. So 3 rounds of sharing, 3 rounds of readings and sharing. First round, just a word, phrase, or line. Second round, why that word, phrase, or line in particular is God's word for you at that moment. Third round, share a prayer in response to the God who has spoken to you through that word. Dano lang kasi. We use that as a most basic startup for Lectio Divina. And there are many other ways of doing this. But I will share to you later on how we repackage the Lectio Divina as an approach to basic Christian communities. But that's going to be for later, maybe for tomorrow morning. In Papago we call it a BFAST, Bible for Faith and Action Sharing Team. But it's really just basically Lectio Divina. And we melded it with the campaign May Day Be One. Because you know that I've headed the commission for 3 terms already on biblical apostolate. And one of our important projects is we produced 5 million Bibles for 5 million poor Filipino Catholics at a subsidized price. You will not find a Bible for 50 pesos. You will get it for 50 pesos because we subsidize the 100 pesos. And this will last only for about 2 more years. And people are not taking advantage of it. You can buy by bulk. You can buy your Bibles by the thousand in any of the 10 major languages available. And we made it possible. But through the Bible, making the Bible a copy of the scriptures available to people in Tagalog, you can organize prayer groups, Bible prayer groups. It is one way of building, you know, small Christian communities. But I'll share with you about that tomorrow. So I hope clear na yung sharing mamaya. The basic lecture to be done. We split into groups, and you will be given copies of the gospel text. The gospel text that I recommend for tonight's lecture divina is John 21:1-21. And that's basically the breakfast by the Sea of Tiberias. Remember that? The disciples coming home with an empty boat, fishing all night and catching nothing. And then later on, Jesus appears to them, the risen Christ. And there's a breakfast by Tiberias. And the dialogue between Jesus and Peter, you know, John chapter 21. So, please read it meditatively and share on this video. Okay. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.